It's lightweight, water-resistant, non-flammable. A low-level demon's fangs and talons are incapable of penetrating that fabric.
What's that?
You plan on traveling with Nezuko, correct? But demons perish when exposed to sunlight. That's why I'm gifting you this box, to carry her during the day. It's built from a very light wood called cloudy cedar. It's been coated in rock lacquer to reinforce the exterior and make it more durable, enough to withstand some abuse.
Oh. Thanks, Urokodaki.
By the way, Tanjiro.
Yes?
Since you're starting out as a demon slayer, there are some things I would like to explain. You should know, there are different kinds of demons. Some demons use a special spell called a blood demon art to give them abilities. You may end up having to face some of them in the near future as well. And fighting against supernatural abilities will be more difficult than anything you've done. However, if you defeat demons and locate their source, you could find the one who turned Nezuko into a demon one day. There's only one demon in the entire world that has the kind of blood that can turn a human. Just one. That's it. The first demon there ever was. He's been here for more than 1,000 years. He's your target, the one who attacked your family. More importantly, I believe he's also the only one who might know how to turn your sister back into a human. That demon's name is Muzan Kibutsuji.
Muzan Kibutsuji. Since he's the only one who can turn humans into demons, that means
he turned Nezuko. Once someone becomes a demon, they'll attack others indiscriminately, even their own family. They can't resist the urge to satiate their hunger with common sense alone. That's what it means to be a demon. At least, that was what I thought. Until I met Nezuko. There's no question that Nezuko is a demon, but in spite of that, she's never devoured a human.
Nezuko was lying on top of her brother like a shield, protecting him. She hasn't eaten anyone.
I've encountered many demons in my lifetime, but never once have I heard of anything like that. The question is, how does she maintain this state? This is only a guess, but I believe Nezuko can recover her strength by sleeping instead of consuming human flesh as other demons do.
Sleeping to recover her strength.
Again, this is only a guess. I could be wrong. Since you are the only one at her side, you must continue to observe her. Understand? And one more thing. I don't know if this will be of any comfort or not, but while Nezuko was asleep, I used hypnotic suggestion on her. All humans are your family. Protect your family. The demons are your enemies. If a demon harms a human, never forgive them. That's what I told her. Tanjiro, I understand that you want to protect your sister, but you must keep in mind, Nezuko is a demon now. She's not a delicate flower who needs your protection. Regardless, this will be your first real mission, where you'll face a demon alone. I hope you both return safe and sound, though I'm sure you'll be fine.
Yes, sir.